Yo, what's good YouTube? It's Pablo and welcome back to GG Sports, and this is another episode of the Madden 19 Cincinnati Bengals rebuild here in Madden 19, and we are in week 2. And in week 1, you guys saw us get an overtime victory versus the Arizona Cardinals. That was a crazy game. If you missed it, go ahead and click the playlist in the description and go back to the previous episode. That was a very good game. But this is going to be a divisional matchup versus the Pittsburgh Steelers. And before we get into that crazy matchup, we're going to look into the players of the week. Andy Dalton did get the honors for his performance last week, throwing the game-winning touchdown in overtime. But the Steelers so far on the season, they did defeat the Baltimore Ravens by a score of 31-17. They only have one player on their injury report, and that is Shaquille Quarterman. But this team, I'm going to give you a warning now. I could not control what they did in the offseason. They do have Le'Veon Bell, and they also still have Antonio Brown. Also, Ryan Shazier. So this team is just pretty much stacked with players that they shouldn't actually have. So this is definitely going to be a tough matchup. Expect it to be very physical. I expect the defense to come out and try to contain the stars that they have on offense. But we're off to a good start as our rookie Trey Lamar, he brings down Ben Roethlisberger for a big loss. Third down and 25 on the same drive. Ben Roethlisberger is trying to go to Smith-Schuster. He'll be intercepted by William Jackson, and we will have great field position, great play by William Jackson, bad throw. That was pretty much double coverage. Sean Williams was right there on the coverage as well, and William Jackson takes full advantage, and that's why he's our number one corner. Great play by him. He continues to get better, and he's making plays early in this game, in this divisional matchup. He knows these mean a lot, and Joe Mixon is going to be brought down, and he will be hurt on the play, and he is going back to the locker room. That is not good. We have great field position. Things are looking good, but we lost Joe Mixon. Hopefully, that is not a bad injury. Stay tuned for more updates. But it will be Giovanni Bernard taking on the workload until he returns. And Andy Dalton just plain misses John Ross going toward the corner of the end zone. Had him on a fade route. He overthrew him out of bounds. But we're going to Giovanni Bernard, who's also going to be hurt. But that will bring up fourth down, and he's also going to be out for the remainder of the game. So we lose our top two running backs on one drive, and that is the first drive of the game. So definitely a very unfortunate start to this game, and we only came away with 3 points, but Pierre Desir deflects that pass. But on the next play, Le'Veon Bell breaks like three tackles, and he is off to the races, and he's going for six. Terrible play defensively. I don't know how we allowed that to happen. We're not going to get the job done tackling like that. And Le'Veon Bell takes full advantage. But on the next drive, TJ Watt, the defensive player of the week for week one, brings down the offensive player of the week for week one. And we are facing third down and 12. Andy Dalton is rolling out to the left-hand side. Nobody accounted for him, and he's able to pick up the full 12 yards and the first down. So on that same drive, second down and 10, play action to Tyler Boyd for a huge pickup. Second down and 9 on the same drive, though, from the 39-yard line. Andy Dalton's going to be brought down at the 46, and that is a huge loss. We're going screenplay on 3rd and 16 to Mark Walton just to try to salvage some yards before we eventually had to punt. And Ben Roethlisberger is going to find Smith-Schuster for a gain of 8 that time. They're going play action on 2nd down to Antonio Brown, and that is a nice pickup there. They move the chains, and our defense really has to make a stand right here. We don't want to allow any more points. But we have a chance to get off the field as Pierre Desir brings down Antonio Brown after a gain of 4. They're going to attempt a field goal from the 49-yard line. That will be nowhere near close to good. And that will be returnable by John Ross, who has the speed to make anything happen. He's going to give us great field position as he gets us close to midfield and play action on second down and seven on that drive. We're going to Uzama actually catches the ball this time, and this pass on third down is almost intercepting Andy Dalton with a risky pass right there. But first down and 10 on their next drive, Geno Atkins will bring down Ben for a loss of about seven, but they eventually got it to third and seven, and they're going to go to Antonio Brown on the left side for a nice gain, beating the coverage of Pierre Desir. First down and 10, Vance McDonald is going to drop this pass. Great play, Drake Kirkpatrick on the coverage. Third down and 10, they will not be able to convert as they dump the playoff to Le'Veon Bell for a small gain. They punt, and Mark Walton is trying to make the most of his chance to shine right here, so he has a nice gain. And then on the next play, it's going to be Andy Dalton rolling out to the right, finding AJ Green. So third down and seven on that same drive, it's going to be John Ross, who is breaking a few tackles and gets us actually inside the 10-yard line. And a couple plays later, it's Mark Walton right up the middle for a touchdown, and we take the lead in this game 7-9. We get the extra point, and that is not a given with Randy Bullock, but a nice run and nice blocking on that drive allowed us to march right down and take the lead. But on first down and 10 on their next drive, we have to play some defense, but Vance McDonald is going to gash this defense for a huge gain. And here is Le'Veon Bell shrugging off about six tackles before he goes into the end zone. Take another look at this play. How many Bengals touched him before he eventually had nothing but daylight in front of him? And that leaves me really salty, to be honest, because he shouldn't be in this game. And on the next drive, third down and 19, we have to get something here, but instead our player will get smacked and we have to punt the football. And on the next drive, as we're trailing 14-10, we're surrendering big plays to Antonio Brown, and here is Le'Veon again making our defense look like little guys until he's brought down at the 37-yard line. Second down and 10, Ben Roethlisberger goes deep to Ryan Switzer, and he's brought down inside the 10, but they'll have to settle for a field goal. That is due to the clock, not our defense, but we go into halftime, luckily only down by a score. This game should really be out of hand for us right now. If you look at the numbers, they're outclassing us in every aspect of this game. Not a good showing by our defense, and then we're also dealing with injuries, as you can add another one to the list on this game. AJ Green is also going out, so this season actually is looking just like last season. We're having a lot of injuries, so we definitely want to avoid that, but the team still is going to try to salvage this game and come out with a victory at home. And Andy Dalton is going to try to get out of bounds as he picks up a huge chunk of yards, and Mark Walton hurdles a defender as he rushes to the left hand side for the touchdown for his second of the day. And this one comes from 21 yards out. Let's take another look at how he was able to swindle the defense. He was surrounded by three Steelers right there, but with that hurdle, I don't know, they lost track of him. But he gets into the end zone nonetheless, and we tie the game. But Ben is going to be brought down, but he does get the ball off to Antonio Brown for a nice gain. And we just can't defend Antonio Brown at this point. And Pierre Desir is looking like barbecue chicken for him right now, for real, because he just got fried again for another long touchdown. That's a 56-yarder for Antonio Brown. I think we should have William Jackson on him, to be honest. I'm not sure how we end up with Pierre Desir on him, but we get the ball back, and we are down 24-17. And Mark Walton catches the screen pass and takes it for a nice gain. And here is him again making the most out of that carry and taking it for a small gain on first down. But on third down later in that drive, is CJ Uzama coming down with a diving catch, converting that third down attempt. Definitely was crucial in this drive. And then Mark Walton brings us inside the 10-yard line. And on second down and goal, Andy Dalton with a clean pocket is going to go over the middle. Pass will be dropped by Mark Walton. Third down and goal now. Andy Dalton back to pass, going fade to John Ross. The play that he missed earlier will now be picked off by Artie Burns. Take another look at this jump ball. Totally underthrew it. Threw it pretty much right to the defender right there. Didn't get enough air. Last time he got too much air. This time he didn't put enough under it, and this time it's picked off. So terrible mistake by Andy Dalton in the red zone right there. Gotta put that where it needs to be and not let it be picked off. So now they have a chance to put this game almost out of reach. 24-17, first down and 10 for the Steelers. Big Ben is going to be sacked by Alec Ogletree, and that will be his first sack of the game for a loss of 9, third down and 19. And that was a huge play because it knocked them back. And then they do have a catch by Vance McDonald. They're going to attempt this field goal, but it will be no good. So our chances to win this game stay alive with that miss. We just have to score some points. But instead, Andy will turn it over, intercepted by Ryan Shazier, walking into the end zone. So two games, two pick sixes for Andy Dalton. Another one through a line drive when he should have put some air under it. So with 5 minutes left in this game, unless the Bengals score here, for all intents and purposes, they will be out of this game. So with third down and 10 in front of them, they're going to pass this one to John Ross, who shrugs off a tackle and takes this play up inside the 20-yard line. Great speed and great play by John Ross. But instead on this play, instead of making a play, he's going to give the defense the football. Fumbles it at the 6-yard line. That will be our second red zone turnover of this game and our second back-to-back on our last two possessions. But on third down and 10 on their next drive with 2 minutes to go, we do force a punt. And with only under a minute to go, you gotta think this game is pretty much over. Third down and 1, we do convert Mark Walton up the middle. And he is emerging in this game with 2 touchdowns. But on second down, Andy Dalton shrugs off a tackle and goes deep to the end zone to John Ross, who tiptoes in the back of the end zone, comes down with the catch for the 43-yard touchdown. Great garbage time play, guys. I mean, great play by John Ross. You like to see him have those confidence builder plays like that. But they do get the ball back and eventually nail this game out. We do lose, and the difference in this game, if you look at it, definitely would be the turnovers in the red zone and the turnovers that turn into points on the other end. Andy Dalton, I'm looking at you. You have 2 pick sixes, and then you give up on the plays after you throw the interceptions. Definitely not a good look. The Steelers, they thoroughly destroyed our defense, had a few home run plays. We have to do better tackling. Hopefully we'll be better next week versus the Cleveland Browns. But the Steelers do continue their dominance over the Bengals, even at home, as we take the loss by a score of 31-24. We're unable to pull off a victory versus the Steelers, but we do get an upgrade for Trey Lamar that brings his overall up. And then also the only lasting injury of this game, which we're thankful for, honestly, because we had 3 key players be injured, is Joe Mixon. He's out with a broken collarbone. He'll be out for 8 weeks. But this was a tough loss. We didn't expect to really win versus the Steelers with a rookie head coach in their first matchup. But Andy Dalton, I think, really has to do better. Our defense has to do better. But next week, we'll play against the Browns, and I don't think their offense is as high-powered as the Steelers. And then in week 1, the Cardinals, they were well-coached and had a good system with Tyrod, David Johnson, and Golden Tate. So maybe our defense will be able to step it up versus the Browns. I hope to see you guys in that next episode. Leave a comment and let me know what you guys thought was the main difference in this game and any improvements that you think I can make on the team. And otherwise, just leave a like and subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Later.